Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. I'm Komi Kavishikhavit and in this video, I'm going to discuss how to run a co-integration test for a data set using eviews. So I have used a panel data. So in this video, I will be discussing how we can run a co-integration test for a panel data in eviews. So I have already imported my data file. So one of the important questions that comes to our mind is, why do we use co-integration test? See, if you want to find out whether your variables have a long-run association or not, in that case, we use co-integration test. Apart from this, one of the most important things that you need to ensure is that before running co-integration test, you need to ensure that all the variables in your data set are stationary at level. Okay, if the variables are not stationary, in that case, you can't proceed with co-integration test. Okay, if you want to learn how do we estimate whether our variables are stationary or not, you can watch my video on unit root test. I'm also attaching the link in the description regarding the same. So let's start with the co-integration test. So first you have to import your data file for which you want to find out whether the variables are co-integrated or not. So this is my data file. Now you have to select all your variables. First, the dependent variable followed by all the independent variables. So I'll select all the variables. Now open all these variables as group. So you can see the data file is opened. Now the steps are as follows. You have to go to quick, then group statistics, and you have to select Johansen Cointegration Test here. So you can see all the variables that are selected are mentioned over here. So first is dependent variable followed by all the independent variables. Click OK. Now see, this is the dialog box for panel co-integration test. As you can see, panel co-integration test is mentioned over here. Now, there are three tests that are mentioned here, which are used for co-integration. These are Pedroni, Kao test, and Fisher combined Johansen test. In this video, I will be explaining how to run Pedroni Cointegration based test and how to interpret the results for the same. Okay, so I'll choose Pedroni test. Now, below this, you can see there are three specifications mentioned over here regarding trend specification. Okay, there is individual intercept, individual intercept, and individual trend, and no intercept or trend. So these are three trend specifications. So we will go systematically. I'll first choose individual intercept. Okay. Now here, either you can choose automatic selection or you can go for user specified. Okay. So I'm selecting here automatic selection. Okay. You can go with user specified also. These are different leg length criteria that are being used for choosing the different lengths and legs for your data set. Now, keep all the things as it is and click OK. Now you can see the results are mentioned over here. Now, how do we interpret the results? See, in case of co-integration, the null hypothesis is there is no co-integration in variables. Or you can see here also, the null hypothesis is mentioned, no co-integration. Whereas the alternative hypothesis is there is a co-integration. Now, how do we conclude? So we follow the same thumb rule of 5% significance. So if the probability value is less than 5% or it is less than 0.05, then in that case, we reject the null hypothesis of no co-integration. If the probability value is less than 0.05, we reject null hypothesis of cointegration and conclude that the variables are cointegrated or the variables have a long-run association. All right. Now, here you can see in Pedroni test, 11 statistics have been calculated. These are panel B statistic, panel row statistic, panel PP statistic, and panel ADF statistics. So four probabilities and four R probabilities for the weighted statistics. And so these are total 8 statistics that have been calculated. Here you can see there are 3 more statistics. These are group row statistic, group PP statistic, and group ADF statistic. Okay, so there are total 11 statistics that have been calculated. Now we will look what the probability values of all these 11 statistics. If the probability value is less than 0.05, then we will reject the null hypothesis. Okay, now you can see here only panel PP statistic and panel ADF statistic for weighted statistics have a value less than 0.05. Okay, so these two have probability less than 0.05, and for group PP statistic and group ADF statistics, these two also have a probability value of less than 0.05. So out of 11 statistics, only 4 statistics report a value less than 0.05. So out of 11, 4 are less than 0.05 and rest are greater than 5%. So 7 are greater than 5%. So we conclude that because 7 statistics are greater than 5%, we do not reject null hypothesis. Okay, it means that the variables are not co-integrated or the variables have no long-run association. Okay. So these were the results under the first trend specification. Now we have to run the same exercise for the rest two specifications. So we'll again go to Johansen Cointegration Test, and now we will select the second trend specification, which states individual intercept and individual trend. So we have to run the same exercise again for this trend specification. So now we select the second one and keep rest of the things as same and click OK. Now the results for second trend specifications are mentioned over here. So you can see again, for this also, we have to check whether out of 11 statistics, how many of the statistics probability value are less than 0.05. Okay. So here you can see again, only 4 probability values are less than 0.05. Panel PP statistics, ADF statistics, group PP statistics, and group ADF statistics. These 4 have a probability value of less than 0.05 and rest are greater than 0.05. So here also we conclude that out of 11 statistics, since only 4 were having a value less than 0.05, so we do not reject the null hypothesis of no cointegration. It means the variables have no cointegration in the long run or do not have a long run association. So second one is also denying the fact of cointegration. Now we'll run this exercise for the third trend specification. So again, go to Johansen Cointegration Test. Okay, now the test type is same, Pedroni. And now select the third trend specification, which states no intercept or trend. Now click OK. Now you can see here the results for the third trend specification are as follows. We can see here also only 4 statistics, probability value is less than 0.05. So out of total 11 statistics, only 4 are less than 0.05, rest are greater than 5%. So we reject the null hypothesis when it is less than 0.05. But the values, total 7 probability values are greater than 5%. So we do not reject the null hypothesis. And we conclude that there is no co-integration between the variables, or the variables do not have a long-run association. So what do we conclude now, finally? So finally, we can conclude that all these variables that were chosen in this data set have no co-integration or have no long-run association based upon Pedroni-Granger based test. Okay, finally, we can conclude that there is no co-integration among the variables that are chosen in the dataset, or the variables have no long-run association according to the Pedroni-Granger based test. So this is how we run the co-integration test of Pedroni. I hope you like the video. Please click on the subscribe button so that you get a notification also whenever a new video is uploaded. Thank you very much.